Welcome back, everyone. Today, we will be discussing scripting and the role it plays in penetration testing. Scripting refers to the creation or execution of sequences of commands or instructions to perform specific tasks. In penetration testing, scripting empowers testers to automate various procedures, interact with systems, and analyze data efficiently. It encompasses a wide array of languages and tools tailored to address different aspects of security testing. And yes, with the rise of AI bots and assistants, you may be wondering, why would you need to learn this anymore? However, AI is still far from perfect, and you still need to understand what AI is writing for you, and thus, I still believe scripting is important for these and many other reasons. In this series, we will go over three different languages, which is Bash, Python, and PowerShell. Scripting plays a pivotal role in penetration testing for several reasons. First of all, it's very handy in automation of repetitive tasks. Penetration testing involves executing numerous repetitive tasks, such as network enumeration, vulnerability scanning, and data analysis. Scripting enables testers to automate these processes, saving time and effort while ensuring consistency and accuracy. Second of all, it allows for customization and flexibility. Off-the-shelf security tools often have limitations in addressing unique testing scenarios. With scripting, testers can develop custom solutions tailored to specific requirements, allowing for greater flexibility and adaptability in diverse testing environments. Thirdly, it also enables enhanced efficiency and productivity. By automating routine tasks and leveraging scripting to perform complex operations, penetration testers can optimize their workflows and maximize productivity. Scripting frees up valuable time that can be allocated to more critical aspects of security assessment and analysis. Fourthly, scripting allows for scalability and reusability. Scripting promotes scalability by enabling testers to create reusable modules and libraries. These components can be leveraged across different projects and engagements, streamlining the testing process and facilitating knowledge sharing within the security community. And lastly, with scripting, you gain deeper understanding of systems. Writing scripts requires a deep understanding of underlying systems, protocols, and vulnerabilities. As testers delve into scripting, they gain insights into inner workings of target environments, enhancing their proficiency in identifying and exploiting security weaknesses. Bash, aka shell scripting, stands as a fundamental skill in the arsenal of a penetration tester, considering you will be most likely using one of the pentesting Linux distros, such as Kali or Parrot, to conduct your assessments. Bash, short for Born Again Shell, serves as a default command line interpreter on most Unix-like operating systems. It provides a powerful environment for executing commands, managing files, and automating tasks through scripting. Bash scripting harnesses the capabilities of the command line interface, allowing users to string together sequences of commands, control program flow with loops and conditional statements, and manipulate data efficiently. Its syntax is intuitive and accessible, making it an ideal choice for both novice and seasoned scripters alike. Bash scripts typically feature a series of commands and directives written in plain text file, often with a .sh extension. Penetration testers frequently navigate through command line interfaces to interact with target systems, retrieve information, and execute various tools and utilities. Bash scripting enables testers to streamline these interactions, automate routine tasks, and expedite the testing process. Furthermore, many security tools and utilities used in penetration testing operate from command line and support integrations with Bash scripting. By leveraging Bash scripting, testers can orchestrate the execution of multiple tools, capture output for analysis, and orchestrate complex attack scenarios seamlessly. Furthermore, Bash scripts offer customization capabilities, allowing testers to tailor scripts to suit specific testing requirements and scenarios, whether it's automating network scans, parsing log files, or conducting reconnaissance activities. Bash scripts provide the flexibility to adapt to evolving testing needs. Also, in resource-constrained environments or scenarios where graphical user interfaces are not available, Bash scripts serve as lightweight yet powerful alternatives for performing critical tasks. They consume minimal system resources and can be deployed across diverse platforms and architectures with ease. Lastly, learning Bash scripting enhances proficiency and skill set of penetration testers, fostering a deep understanding of Linux and Unix-based systems, command line utilities, and shell environments. As testers explore Bash scripting, they gain insights into systems internals, file operations, and process management, augmenting their expertise in security assessment and exploitation techniques. Now, let's go over some of the basic shell commands. Familiarity with basic Linux commands is necessary for navigating through file systems, interacting with processes, and manipulating data during tests. Here are some of the key Linux commands. Note that this is a non-exhaustive list, and we're only going over the basics. You can also find the list of these commands in the description of the video. First, we have ls, which simply lists directory contents. Following, we have cd, which stands for change directory. Next, we have pwd, which stands for print working directory, which simply displays the current folder or directory that you're in. Next, we have mkdir, which creates a new directory or folder for you. rm removes files and directories. You can use cp to copy files and to copy directories as well. Move you can use to move file or folder in another location or to simply rename the file or the directory. Then we have grep, which can help you search for patterns in files. Cat concatenate and displays the file contents. Echo displays messages or variables. Chmod changes the file permission, while chown changes the file ownership. PS displays information about active processes that are running on your system, and kill can terminate the process. Find can search for files or directories in your system, following by cut, which can extract specific fields or columns from delimited text files, log files, and command output. We also have TR, which stands for translate. It performs character level translation or substitution operations on input data streams. Second last, we have sed, which is a versatile stream editor, and it enables testers to perform text manipulation, search and replace operations, and pattern-based transformation on input streams and files. Lastly, we have awk, which provides testers with a robust toolkit for data extraction, manipulation, and reporting tasks. Now that we went over some of these commands, let's have a quick demo using them. We will begin using bash for file and directory management. Imagine you're in the midst of a security assessment and you realize that various evidence files are accumulating and soon your directory will become a big mess. Before it gets to that point, you decide you want to keep it neat and organized. In this demo, we will do just that by cleaning things up and securing important files. Instead of using graphic interface for this, we will use bash, and by the way, you can find the link to the bash script to generate the example setup in the video's description. Let's begin by generating the lab material. It has not asked me for a sudo, aka administrator password here, because I've already sudoed in this terminal. However, it will ask you, and this is because we need to copy one of the log files from one of your root-owned directories into the example lab. Now that the lab material has been created, let's go into that folder. And as you can see, we've already used one of the commands that I've mentioned earlier, which is cd, which is used for changing directories. To begin, let's see our current folder and what it contains. To see our current folder, we can use pwd. And here you can see we are inside the file management directory, which is in turn inside the bashlab.1 directory. Next, let's list the files in our lab directory by running ls. Here we got a number of files. Ls simply lists all non-hidden files in the current directory. But what if there were any hidden files? We can see hidden files and file details by running ls la. The L flag uses a long listing format, and a flag indicates to list all, even hidden files. You can also achieve the exact same thing by running la without the ls. Let's break down the output without getting too deep into the specifics. The first column shows file permissions. The second column shows the number of hard links to the file. The third and fourth columns show the owner and group of the file. The fifth column shows the file size. The sixth column shows last modified date and time, and finally the file name. Dot and double dot represent current and parent directories. Here we have the hidden files that LS itself did not show. Notice all of the hidden files begin with a dot. To expand this even further, we can use ls-lahht. And T here sorts the files by last modified date, with the most recent file at the top. H makes sizes human readable by displaying unit measurements. In this case, look at the current directory, which shows 4 kilobytes instead of 4096 bytes, as we do with LSLA. This is very useful when checking which files were changed recently. Now that we see what's in our directory, let's organize some of these files into folders. However, first we need to create these folders. We will use mkdir to do that. Mkdir creates a directory. The p flag prevents errors if the directory already exists. Next, let's move files with YAML extension into config directory. Here we can use asterisk, aka the wildcard, to select all of the YAML files. Let's run ls again, first of all to make sure that the directory was created, and as you can see, all of the YAML files are not in our current directory. We can list the contents of config directory with ls configs, and as you can see, all of our YAML files are present there. Now let's move files with .log extension into log directory. And let's check again if they have moved. Yep, none of our log files are there anymore. At times, you may want to make a copy of some of your files. In this case, let's make a backup of our log files in case you want to modify the content, however, still require the original. Let's create a backup directory within logs directory and copy our log files into there. First of all, let's use mkdir logs, and we will create another directory called backup. And as you can see, we have a new directory called backup within logs directory. And now let's copy all of the log files to logs.backup. We had no problem of moving logs. However, we cannot copy boot.log file because the permission is denied. As you can see here, all of the other files my user is the owner of. However, here root is the owner, and as such, we get an error. And I guess that's a good time to perhaps talk about our permissions. Every file and directory in Linux has three permission types for three user categories. There is owner, then there is group, and then there is others. Owner is the user who owns the file. Group is users in the same group as the owner, and others is everyone else. You have R and W, and here we have an X as well. R stands for read, and its numeric value is 4. W stands for write, and its numeric value is 2. X stands for execute, and its numeric value is 1. It does not make sense yet, but as soon as we start using chmod, you will see why the numbers matter. Since logs may contain sensitive data, let's restrict access so only we can read them. Let's head into logs directory, and for now let's modify all of our example logs and set strict permissions on these files. So when we first began, the permissions was read and write for our user, read for the people in the group, and also read for everyone else. Now we have read and write only for our user, and that's it. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention here, D stands for directory. If there is no D and it's just a dash, that means it's a file. Do you remember I've mentioned that read has numeric value of 4 and write has numeric value of 2? Well, that's how we get the 6 in chmod. It would be 7 if we would have all three, read, write, and execute. As you remember the permission error we've got earlier for boot.log, that was because we have used root permission to copy this file as per the script. To fix that, we need to use chown in the following way. We will do sudo chown user user boot.log. So sudo runs a command with admin privileges, which were needed since the files were owned by root. Chown changes the file ownership. User column user set current user as both owner and group owner. And finally, bootlog was the name of the file we applied to. We can also use echo to check the current user variable. And as you can see, it's AL, which matches here as well. Now, if we do LSLA, we can see that the ownership of abu.log changed to AL. We've now cleaned up our workspace and locked down our important files. Let's quickly go over the steps again. We started with basic file listing, ls, lsla, lslaht. Then we organized files into logs and configs using mkdir and move and cp command. And lastly, we secured the logs using chmod and chown. I will also post a separate bonus video on how to use data manipulation command that we mentioned in the middle of this video by exploring an SSH log file. Hope to see you there. In conclusion, scripting plays an important role in penetration testing, offering testers the ability to automate tasks, customize solutions, and streamline workflows effectively. Throughout this discussion, we've explored the significance of scripting, particularly focusing on bash scripting as a fundamental skill for penetration testers. Bash scripting provides a powerful environment for executing commands, managing files, and processing text, among other things, making it a good skill in the arsenal of the penetration tester. By employing bash scripting, testers can enhance their efficiency, productivity, and proficiency in conducting security assessments and exploitation techniques. In the next video, we will go over the basic elements of a script and the structure of bash scripts. See you there!